Hi, I'm Barb Russo, an assistant professor of Fire and Emergency Services Administration and the program director for Fayetteville State's FESA program. I've been asked to share with you some of the strategies and tactics that have allowed me to be named one of FSU's top 10 advisors for 2013-2014. My very first captain in the fire service said to me my first day on the job, "Russo, I can teach a monkey to catch a fire hydrant." Yep, he was correct. It doesn't take much talent. It's a repetitive action, so if you do it a few times, it becomes second nature. In that same breath, I can tell you that not everyone can be an advisor, yet alone a good one, and I'm going to share with you why. First of all, to be a good advisor, you want to be one in the first place. So if you don't like advising or not good at advising, then don't do it. Speak with your chair and find another way to contribute. Some of us are better than others, and that's a harsh reality. But to allow someone who is not vested in the process to advise is a huge mistake. Students pick up on this, and it's not fair nor a sound practice, so tap out if you can't hang in this area. Secondly, good advisors are good mentors first. That's right, I said mentors. Go back to the quote I opened with, you know, the monkey. Some people can advise on cruise control. It's not rocket science to read a cap or to look at a program in the catalog. I can literally advise for every single program out here confidently and accurately. What my students appreciate most, and it is reflected time and time again on evaluations, is that I take the time to listen to them, understand what they have going on in their lives, and allow them to make sound academic decisions. I'm not here to cram courses down their throats for the sake of increasing SEHs. Some students will be set up for failure if I were to do so. I almost forgot to mention to you all, I have 115 advisees. Yes, 115. All of them are working adults, mid-career fire service professionals, and are scattered across the state. So if you're complaining about the five or so you may have, then maybe there's something you can do better. So here's my third recommendation. Advising, yes, good advising, is a continuous process. It doesn't go on just twice a year when students get ready to pre-register for an upcoming term. It is year-round. I know where my students are, they know where they are, and they're able to take charge of the pace they advance through the program. So how's this all managed? Through the simple use of a site I created in Blackboard. All FESA majors are inserted into a shell that is virtually self-service center for all that is advising and all that is the FESA program. They have access to all of the common registrar forms in one single place, withdrawals, permission forms, etc. They have curriculum information, FESHI information for their accredited program, all of their syllabi, all major meeting PowerPoints, academic calendars, and a section for rules and regulations that dictate various policies here on campus. Finally, I hold all majors meetings via Adobe Connect at least 4 times a year. This gives me an opportunity to keep the students connected to the program and the university, and they enjoy being able to see one another and ask questions in live time. For those unable to attend, the recording is made available. I do require that they watch it, though, as they're held accountable for everything that I cover. So it really is that simple. If you want to be a good advisor, simply adopt one or more of these strategies and tactics. You don't need to reinvent the wheel. I can tell you everything that I have shared with you I developed from having a great advisor of my own. As a graduate student at Oklahoma State University, I had the privilege of studying under Drs. Brenda Phillips and David Neal. They took the time to understand where I was at, where I was headed, and had it not been for them investing time in me, I wouldn't be sitting here today.